When Henry was diagnosed with SMA, it was the scariest moment in our lives as parents.
Spinal muscular atrophy is one of the most devastating diagnoses that we are trained to give.
When they said the words, we knew that they were bad because of the way the doctor even said it to us in the neuro office.
My wife Emily was crying. Our doctor, we know, very close with, she was crying.
And then we Googled it, and it was bad. Bad. We were told he would never walk, eat on his own, breathe on his own, sit up.
It's really a death sentence because all of these babies will die before they turn one or two without extreme treatments such as, you know, ventilatory support, tracheostomy, and a breathing machine. And most family, they just decide to take their babies home and let the disease take its course.
We made a big mistake by Googling what SMA was, and that was probably the dumbest thing we could have done because nothing on the internet was positive at all. It was, you know, death, 18 months.
We heard about gene therapy during our research of SMA. We were just trying to find anything, grasp onto anything that could help him with this terminal condition.
So what this new treatment, gene therapy, does, it has the ability to replace the gene in all the cells that innervate the muscle, and it does so very rapidly so that those cells right away can start producing the missing protein and allow the muscle to develop normally.
We found it was not FDA approved yet, and so we were basically Googling every doctor on the East Coast that could give our son this gene therapy under the Compassionate Care Act. And everyone said, no, we don't give it under the Compassionate Care Act. No, you know, they don't have any way set up yet to do it, until we saw a little boy online that received it through Dr. Cefalone at Strong.
We were in a different hospital. He was in the PICU for a month with aspiration pneumonia. And she saw in a SMA support group on Facebook, and she wrote a very, very nice letter and sent a picture of him.
Who can deny that smile?
And we thought, you know, it's worth a try. And so one of the heads of the companies out in Chicago gave Megan a call. It was them telling us there was a possibility that he would receive the gene therapy through the Compassionate Care Law.
This is done with an IV infusion, and the results and the improvement happens quite rapidly in the very first few weeks after treatment.
It was a beyond emotional day for us when he actually had, you know, the stuff starting to go into him, a little, you know, vial like this.
We're definitely seeing both immediate and longer lasting results. Immediately, mm-hmm. we noticed that he was capable of having a productive cough.
He wasn't able to do that
I
before.
Didn't think I would ever be so excited for one of my children to, like, spit on me, like, cough something up onto my hand. You would have thought I won the lottery that day.
It has taken 50 years of gene therapy research to get us here.
He is so lucky that he was born now. Even if he were born 2 or 3 years ago, he wouldn't have these options that he does now. And prior to Henry receiving gene therapy, he was hospitalized 4 times for respiratory illnesses. After receiving gene therapy in February, he hasn't been hospitalized once.
He says Dada, for the record.
He says Mama, too, just not as frequently.
I never heard it yet.
The short time, the amount since we had gene therapy, just the massive improvements we've seen from him physically, the things that he even just taking a walk around the neighborhood, which wasn't even an option before, mm-hmm. that now we can do that. And he wants to sit up, and he's pulling his feet, and he's watching birds fly, and normal kid things.
Yeah.
This gene therapy is a complete game changer. We are over the moon grateful that Liam was able to receive it because we have noticed such a huge, huge change.
I think things would have been a lot different.
And now we know that we have a different future.
It's going to be a great story moving forward for all of our family and patients.
We just can't thank Dr. Shepherd and her team enough. Just finding all those options there for us.
Yeah, she just really changed our son's life.
Honest to God, there are no words that can ever truly convey the appreciation that we feel to saving our son's life.